Hey guys, welcome back. I'm Ian Laspina, and today I just want to share my thoughts on the video by Lindy Beige that has been circulating around about the longbow versus breastplate, which will win. I wanted to share my thoughts as a lot of people have been asking me about what I thought about that test, so here we go. I think it's a really good test and a very valuable data point in a sea of a lot of kind of invalid data points out there. Most of the tests that are conducted out there favor one side drastically compared to the other. We often see things like really low draw weight bows, like 30 or 40 pound bows being shot at armor, and you know that doesn't really tell us anything. It's nowhere close to the weight of actual war weight longbows. You don't even need to do the test. We know that it's not going to penetrate the armor. On the other side of things, we see people that are using the proper bows, you know, things like 130, 140 pound draw weight longbows, except they're shooting against things like aluminum mail or flat pieces of steel plate or just really junky low-end armor that is not an analog to how historical armor would have behaved. And it doesn't, again, it doesn't tell us how armor behaves against an arrow because we're missing the armor. What I like about this test is that it uses high quality objects on both sides of the test. So on the bow side, we have a high quality self-U bow somewhere in the neighborhood of 140 to 150 pound draw weight, according to the latest information from the shooter, with a proper war weight arrow and a proper war weight arrowhead on it. On the armor side, we have a very good reproduction of the Kerberg number 14 breastplate. The reproduction is made from 0.6% carbon steel and hardened to about 400 on the Vickers scale, or about 41 and change on the Rockwell hardness scale. And it's 1.8 mils thick in the center, very similar to the original. And that is information from the armor, Albert Collins of Via Armorari. Now, yes, this breastplate is hardened. So is that representative of all armor of the 14th century? No, of course not. Only a percentage, a small percentage of armor in the 14th century was actually hardened. So that is something to keep in mind. As time goes on, the frequency of hardened armor becomes greater. But don't get wrapped up in only the materials. Another thing that goes a long way in an armor's ability to resist penetration is its proper shaping. That's why I cringe when I see people using plates of steel, flat plates of steel, or really low-end armor, because it doesn't get the shaping right, and the shaping is what makes it armor. Compound curvature on a breastplate means that it never presents a perpendicular to the weapon that it's receiving. So an arrow is at its most advantageous when it can strike on a perpendicular. Properly shaped armor doesn't let the arrow hit on a perpendicular. And the other thing to consider is that when this armor is in use for real, you know, it's not just sitting on the ground static, or a person's not standing there squared up against an archer. They're in motion. So the odds of that arrow being able to strike at its most advantageous angle are incredibly low. So when we look at this test, we see high quality objects on both sides of the test, and we see the demonstration that, oh my God, armor works. Yes, of course it does, or people wouldn't wear it. Well, what about all of the historical accounts of people in armor being defeated by arrow shot? One thing you have to understand is when a chronicler is dedicating time to talk about something in a chronicle, like people, the horror of people being killed by arrows in their armor, he's writing about it because it's an exceptional, noteworthy case. It's not representative of what the norm was. If everybody knew that anybody who wore armor could just be defeated by a heavyweight war bow, well, why would you bother wearing all that armor if it doesn't do anything to protect you? So these were noteworthy cases. They were exceptional circumstances where people in armor were being defeated. And to go even further, almost none of those accounts actually say that the armor itself was defeated. When you're talking about massed arrow shot, the odds of those arrows finding the spots on armor that are only protected by mail or places that aren't directly protected by plate are a lot higher. So that's something to consider as well. So yes, I really like the test that was being done at the Visby reenactment. I'd love to see more scientific testing along those lines using high quality objects on both sides. So that's what I had to say about that. Hope you guys enjoyed, and thanks for watching. Till next time, bye.